Good morning. My name is Harry Stillerman, and I'm the Vice President for Institutional Advancement and Development here at Piedmont Virginia Community College. And I have the distinct honor and privilege of delivering a sentence that a lot of us have been waiting to hear for a very, very long time. Welcome to the groundbreaking ceremony for the Woodrow W. Bolick Advanced Technology and Student Success Center. Now, you may be thinking to yourself, Harry, isn't the building going to be constructed behind us? Yes. One of the great things about working for someone that's been a community college president for 23 years is that they have a lot of foresight. And so we had a conversation about how unfortunate it would be for Frank to end his 23 years of, as a president with lots of people falling down the hill. And so we decided that everybody could just maybe use their imagination. And there'll be plenty of time for us to look into the meadow and see the sight lines for the building shortly. We're really here today to do three things. Let me start though by saying we've planned a really brief program, but we don't want the brevity of this program to take away from the significance of this moment. This is a really big deal and we are really excited. So we want to do three things. The first is, as you can imagine, a significant project like this doesn't happen without the help of a lot of really, really wonderful folks and organizations working really hard. And so we're going to spend a little bit of time recognizing those people that have helped make this day possible. The second thing is we want to share a little bit of information with you about the programs that are going to be housed in this wonderful facility and the impact that it's going to make for our college, our students, and our community in the generations to follow. And then last and most importantly, we're going to turn some dirt. So before we get started, I want to make just some brief introductions and welcome. I am going to formally introduce each of our speakers today. But let me just start first by asking if there are, any elected officials and community leaders with us from the seven jurisdictions that are served by PVCC, including Albemarle County, Buckingham County, Fluvanna County, Greene, Louisa, and Nelson counties, and the city of Charlottesville. Please stand if you're here with us today or wave. Fantastic. I want to recognize the members of our PVCC College Board that are here with us today. Please wave. Perfect. I want to recognize the members of our PVCC Educational Foundation Board that are here. Not to be forgotten, do we have any former College Board members or Educational Foundation Board members with us today? Fantastic. Representatives from the VCCS? Great, welcome. Friends, partners, and supporters and donors? Welcome. And finally, PVCC faculty, staff, and students. And if you haven't stood up or raised your hand in that group, please do so now. We need to get you more connected to PVCC. With that, it's my great pleasure at this time. I don't think we could think of anybody more deserving of giving a welcome in the seven jurisdictions that we serve than our College Board Chair, Lola Richardson. So please join me in welcoming Lola to bring greetings.
Well, you can breathe. We are here. Greetings and a good morning to all of you from your PVCC College Board. Your College Board extends to you a warm, hearty welcome. Vision with action makes a powerful reality. Welcome to this historic vision that is now a reality for the PVCC community and PVCC family. Today, we celebrate the groundbreaking ceremony of our new Woodrow W. Bolick Advanced Technology and Student Success Center. The PVCC Board appreciates your presence today for being a part of the awesome PVCC family. Today is a historic day. This day would not have come to be if it had not been for the hard work, endless hours, dedication, and making this vision a passion by Dr. Frank Freeman and his amazing leadership team. Paraphrasing Benjamin Franklin, without continual growth, without vision, without passion for your vision, and without progress, these words as improvement, achievement, and success would have no meaning. Again, greeting from your College Board, and welcome to this historic day, the birth of a vision becoming a reality. Thank you.
Thank you, Lola. And now it's my pleasure to welcome President Frank Freeman to come and deliver some remarks. Before I do that, I want to make sure that I give credit today to Frank for planning such beautiful weather. And as long as the rain holds out for a few more minutes, I'm sure he will continue to take credit for that. As you all know, Dr. Freeman has done a fantastic job of leading this college for the last 23 years, and it's hard to imagine a better cake topper than the Woodrow W. Bolick Advanced Technology and Student Success Center coming out of the ground today. So please join me in welcoming Dr. Freeman.
Thanks, Harry. I just want to add my welcome to everybody. We're so glad you're here. We don't do this very often. The last groundbreaking was on October 15, 2008, for the building right down the road. It's kind of hidden by the trees, the Keats Science Building. That's been a long time. We are so glad to be here after talking about this building probably for about 7 or 8 years in the planning and finally leading up to today. Let me tell you a little bit about the building. It's going to be 45,000 square feet, and it really serves three major purposes. First purpose, it will house technology programs, especially our programs that are really in a growth mode for programs like cybersecurity, for advanced manufacturing, robotics, lasers, all of the technical skills that go along with advanced manufacturing. So technology is one component. Second component is all of the student onboarding activities. If you're gonna be a new student, you gotta go through admissions, advising, financial aid, all of those services, the cashier. And for the last 50 years, that has taken you on a trek through the old building that wasn't always easy to navigate. Now it will all be together to better serve our students. And then the third component is a student center. We will move our food service into the building. We will have meeting rooms for student clubs and student organizations. We'll have a veterans center. We'll have a student government association office. We'll have all of the more typical trappings of a student center, something that we really haven't had. In fact, those of you who know our current student center, I always describe it as a perfect student center if we were a college of 500 students. The problem is we're 5,000 students, and this building will help us create the kind of atmosphere that we want so that our students are fully engaged and have a comprehensive collegiate experience here at PVCC. So those are the three components of the building. Let's talk about one other component of the building. We are extremely happy and extremely proud that this will be the first net zero building, meaning it will be 100% alternative energy, the first one in the Virginia Community College system, and one of the few that will exist in higher ed in the Commonwealth. And we are extremely excited about that. So let's talk a little bit about how we're paying for this, and I hope we are. The Commonwealth of Virginia, thanks to the work of the General Assembly, has put forward about $20 million for the construction. And that includes $4 million that was literally added a little bit late in the game and after the fact by Governor Northam in order to make the net zero possible. That costs an additional $4 million, and we were very pleased that the governor allocated that money to the project. In addition, our foundation, and many of you are the leaders of the foundation or donors to the foundation, our foundation is putting up about $4 million towards the construction, and our seven local jurisdictions are putting up a little bit over $1 million towards the construction. I think that just shows you how dedicated our local leaders are to educating their citizens and how important this college's work is to building thriving communities and a thriving economic development in each of those seven jurisdictions. Their support has been tremendous. So if you add all that up, we have about $25 million or so, and that's what it's going to take to construct the building. Now I need to say a lot of thank yous, and that always worries me because undoubtedly I leave people out who I shouldn't leave out, and then I hear from them later. So if I leave you out, I apologize right up front, but I do want to send out some thank yous. Bert Jones sitting here in the front row, the Associate Vice Chancellor for Facilities at the Virginia Community College System. Let's face it, without Bert and his staff, we wouldn't be here. We wouldn't have this building going up. So thank you, Bert. Want to recognize our wonderful architects. Those of you who are local, you know VMDO, one of the greatest firms you'll ever deal with. We're going to hear from Kim in a few minutes, but I want to send out a thank you to Joe Atkins, to Kim Thompson-Smith, and the entire VMDO team. They've done a wonderful job. Our general contractor, Gulf Seaboard, they're represented right back there in the corner. We're so anxious for you guys to get started and to work with you on this project. A special thank you needs to go out in terms of how this became that net zero, 100% alternative energy building. It started, quite honestly, with our college sustainability committee. And I saw Bruce Glasgow, where there is Bruce. Bruce chairs that, and that is our committee that's really looking at making us better use of recycling, better use of alternative energy as we go forward. And Bruce was, well, just hammering away at me, right, Bruce? Frank, we got to do something. And that started the ball rolling. And I also want to recognize one of our board members. I don't think she's here, Janet Morrow, who picked up that torch and became a real leader in saying, yes, let's look at how we're constructing this building. That then moved to former delegate David Toscano, and we owe a great debt of thanks to David, and finally, all the way to the governor. And as you know, Governor Northam had made moving the Commonwealth to a greater use of alternative energy one of his priorities, and this certainly fit. And thanks to all those leaders who pushed me, ultimately we pushed the governor, and that's how the $4 million came our way and this became a net zero building. So a huge thank you to all of them. Lastly, a thank you to every single donor to our foundation who has helped make this possible. Our commitment to the Commonwealth was that our foundation would put up 20% of the cost of the building. That was to kind of push it along in terms of being a priority for the Commonwealth. And we couldn't have done that without the generous support of all of our donors. The most generous support of all of those donors is represented by great friends of this college who just received the college medallion at graduation last week, and that is Jim and Cynthia Stoltz. They have been lead donors, and I think Cynthia is going to be speaking to us in a few minutes, so I'm not going to steal her thunder. I'll let her tell you some details. Let me just close by saying, let's keep our eye on what's really important. Although we're here to celebrate this building, what's really important is what goes on inside the building. That's where the teaching and learning will take place. That's where the engineering technologists, the cybersecurity experts, the robotics experts, that's where they're all going to be educated. Many of them will stay here in Central Virginia, and they will be working on projects throughout Central Virginia. That's what's really important. The building will give us world-class facilities to support our world-class faculty, and that's what they will need to deliver that world-class instruction and help our students thrive and help our communities thrive. That's what we should be celebrating today. The bricks and mortar are wonderful. We couldn't do it without that, but it's what goes on inside, person to person, faculty to student, staff member to student. That's where the real action takes place, and that's why we exist as a college, and I think that's what we do so very well. So thank you all for being here. This is a really exciting time for us. And now I am going to ask Cynthia to come up and say a few words. Cynthia?
In 1966, Governor Mills Godwin said, if we look at the numbers of potential students, and if we look at the relative cost involved, the implication is clear that a community college system is the quickest, the most efficient, the most economical. In fact, virtually the only way the future of young people can be met. To that end, he appointed Dr. Dana Hamill, who some called a visionary and a Virginia legend, to be the first chancellor of the community college system. Dr. Hamill said, community colleges are there to educate our workforce and respond to whatever industries decide to do. And he also said that the system's early partnerships with higher education were paying off and predicted that it will become the norm for students to spend the first 2 years at a community college and then transfer to a four-year university. Dr. Friedman has made these visions a reality at PVCC by welcoming and encouraging any student who wants to study here, and by trying to remove financial barriers with his innovative PVCC for You program, which provides free tuition for those who meet the qualifications. I was going through a file of my dad's memorabilia and came across the picture of the groundbreaking in 1972. He mentioned to me that the architects and builder took the board onto this vacant piece of land across from the old Blue Ridge Hospital to show them where the new building would be sited. He said they were stumbling in divots on the ground, getting caught up in briars, and the ladies were complaining that they hadn't dressed appropriately. I happened also to find a daily calendar sheet where Dad had scribbled some notes that he wanted to share and his remarks at the Bolick Student Center dedication. See, he didn't like to waste paper, so. He said that at the groundbreaking, he looked over to Dr. Dana Hamill and said, if Thomas Jefferson looks down to see us building this community college, between his beautiful and beloved Monticello and his beloved University of Virginia, he will surely turn over in his grave. Dr. Hamill then said in his remarks that someday over 5,000 students would attend PVCC. But Dad said that the board couldn't imagine that much growth, given that the enrollment then was in the hundreds. As you know, my dad was appointed to serve on the first PVCC board. And at one of the first board meetings, Grace Carpenter, a fellow board member, said that he was responsible for suggesting the name that the members voted for, Piedmont Virginia Community College. Dad knew that this community college would impact our community in a huge way. And thankfully, he lived long enough to see much of its success. Dad remained passionate about Piedmont throughout his life, attending graduations on the lawn behind the main building well into his 80s. I thought this day would never come, but finally here we are looking towards the future. This building is long overdue and much needed in order to continue to serve our students and offer new programs. The board started talking about the new building probably around 2016. And shortly after we learned about it, Jim and I arranged a meeting with Frank to talk about continuing my father's legacy at the college. After several years of going through the state budget process and finally making the cut for capital projects, wouldn't you know, the COVID pandemic came along, but somehow we prevailed and our building survived the budget. We can attribute this in large part to Frank's dedication to the college and his utter tenaciousness throughout the process. My dad also said in his remarks at the Bolick dedication, it has been an honor and a pleasure to have been associated with PVCC since the very beginning. This is a momentous day for the future of PVCC. And Jim and I, like my dad was then, are so proud and honored to be a part of it.
Thank you, Cynthia, for those wonderful remarks. Thank you, Jim. And I don't think we had the chance to introduce them earlier. We're also joined today by Cynthia's sisters, Sandra and Lori, and we are just delighted that you all could be with us today to celebrate as well. And Cynthia, I would say that Mr. Jefferson has a really pretty landscape to be looking down on now. So, okay. At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce Kim Thompson-Smith with VMDO Architects, who's going to bring some remarks.
So thank you all. I appreciate the opportunity to be here to celebrate this moment for PVCC and VCCS and represent the design team on this project. This is a special day indeed for VCCS. The future students at Piedmont Virginia Community College and the city of Charlottesville and Albemarle County and the surrounding communities we serve. The college's commitment to students and staff, to workforce training, and to our community development partners is evident in the design of this net zero building, the Woodrow W. Bolick Advanced Technology and Student Success Center. It's scheduled for completion in the late winter of 2023. This building will be a gathering space for students. It'll be complete with a café, meeting rooms, and games areas. It'll be a place for learning, robotics, manufacturing, cybersecurity, and a central location, a much needed central location for student admissions, advising, financial aid, and career services. Co-locating all of these functions in one building sends an important message to all. PVCC and VCCS are leading the way in higher education in their commitment to clean energy in Virginia. VMDO is proud to be a part of this history. I want to acknowledge the hard work of the VCCS and PVCC administration and the gift of the Bolick family, the team of VMDO architects in the Charlottesville office, and our engineering partners who contributed to this project, Draper Aiden, Fox & Associates, Salas O'Brien, and CMTA, the Net Zero Consultants. They're all dedicated to creating the design of this net zero building. We look forward to working with Gulf Seaboard and their construction team, who will install the 40 wells in the geothermal well field and the 1,062 PV panels that will adorn the top of the building and the parking canopy. Without the hard work of all those mentioned, the first higher ed net zero building in the Commonwealth would not be possible. Thank you all.
Thank you, Kim. And at this time, we'll hear from Lou Kadiri, who is the Director of State Operations for Senator Mark Warner's office. Lou?
Thank you so much for having me here today. I know the Senator is a big fan of President Friedman and a huge supporter of the Virginia Community College System, and regrets that he can't be here, but he did send along a brief message. Dear friends, I'm pleased to extend my warmest greetings to all who are gathered here for the groundbreaking ceremony. Providing a high-quality education to Virginians contributes to their personal and professional success and bolsters the Commonwealth's economy. Since first opening in 1972, Piedmont Virginia Community College has been dedicated to this endeavor and has adapted to help prepare students for successful careers in high-demand industries. This new center is another step forward in advancing this work, as it will offer workforce training, career development programs in areas like cybersecurity, advanced manufacturing, electronics, and welding. And it will also act as an important hub for student services in a net zero energy building. I commend all those who have worked to make this innovative center possible and look forward to the impact that it will have in the Commonwealth. I send my best wishes for a successful and meaningful event. Sincerely, Senator Mark Warner. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Lou. And believe it or not, we've gotten to the big moment. So before I invite a few folks to come up, I do want to make just some really quick last thank yous. I want to thank Kim McManus and the building and grounds team here at PVCC for putting this wonderful space together today. It looks wonderful. Thank you. I want to thank Susan Brooks and the media and marketing relations team here at PVCC for helping make sure that we can capture all this today and helping get the word out to have such a wonderful crowd. So thank you. I'd also like to say that I see Pouncer the Panther there, and we can now safely dispel the rumors that Jim Stoltz is the mascot. So. We're going to do some waves of pictures, so get loose, get ready. But at this time, I'd like to invite our platform party to come forward, as well as Bert Jones, and grab a shovel and a hard hat, and we're going to take a ceremonial picture. So. We're We're going to do a couple waves of this. So at this time, I'd like to ask all the members of our college board to come forward. At this time, I'd like to ask if there are any of our elected officials that are with us today that want to come up and take a picture. Now I'd like to ask the members of our Educational Foundation Board to come forward.